I'm going to show you how to performance tune your indexes to make them the fastest they can possibly be for searching data. We're going to do this by creating a covering index, which is able to satisfy an entire query without needing to do a lookup to the source table. If any or all of those words sound intimidating, let's do a quick recap. Here I have a Postgres database with a table called people, and if we were to count the number of rows in this people table, we can see it takes a very long time, and that's because there are over 10 million rows in this table. If we were to select all of the columns from the people table where the username column was equal to John, we can see this is taking a very long time, and if I edit out the rest of that waiting, we're actually only selecting back one row. We can prepend this query with explain space analyze, and this will tell us just how long this query takes to give us back that one row. And it's about 16,990 milliseconds, or around 17 seconds, which is way too long for the user to be waiting to get back one row. We can significantly improve this by creating an index on the people table for that username column. And if we highlight this one statement, we can run it on its own, which will take a while. But once that's done, we can run our query again to select our John user, but get our results significantly faster, only a couple of milliseconds, because it was able to perform an index scan rather than a sequential scan, which checks every row in the table, which starts at the first row and says, is this John? And then looks at the next row and says, is this John? And so on until it finds that John user. The high level takeaway here is that indexes are fast. If you want to go deeper than that, check out the video linked at the end of this one. But something I teased in that video is that we can actually improve the efficiency of this query even further by only selecting the username column. So selecting all of the columns took 2.5 milliseconds, and if we select just the username, we can see that took 0.1 milliseconds. And this is because an index is just a copy of the value in that column stored in a data structure that Postgres knows how to search very, very quickly. It also contains a pointer back to that row in the original table in case we need to fetch extra columns that aren't in that index. But if you're not asking for any of those extra columns, it doesn't need to do that extra lookup. So in the case where we're just selecting the username, the index already has a copy of that username that it's using to find this John user. So it has everything it needs to respond to this query. So there's no need to look up John in the people table to get their ID, whether or not their account is active, all of those extra columns that we have in the people table. So we can see Postgres was able to do an index only scan using our username index. So much faster than needing to look up those extra columns. And this problem grows exponentially, well, maybe linearly. This problem grows as the number of rows that need to be looked up from that original table grows. So if we're just selecting the username, but where that John user has an H in their name, I happen to know that both in this table and real life, there are a lot more of them than those cool Johns with no H. And so if we run that one again, looking for those mutant Johns, we can see it took a little bit longer, so 4 milliseconds, still not a problem. But if we expand this column a little bit, we can see there are approximately 3,307 Johns with an H. But again, our index was able to satisfy that entire query because it's a copy of that username column. So if we were to instead select all of those columns, meaning we'll need to look up all of those additional columns from the people table, we'll see it took just over a second. So this is the difference between having an index and having a covering index. Covering indexes are fantastic and super performant. You should probably consider using them for your most expensive and frequently used queries. And thankfully, they're really easy to create in Postgres with the include keyword. This allows us to include any bits of data we want alongside that column that we want to be searchable. So if our application only cares about the email column, but we're searching for that user based on their username, if we run this query against our database, we'll see it uses our index to quickly find that username. But then because we also need that email column, it needs to look up that row in the people table. Again, 3 milliseconds ain't bad, especially for over 3,000 rows, but we can do better. Let's include that email column alongside our username index. So firstly, let's drop our index on username, which we can see here is people_username_IDX. So that's the name that we'll need to use here, people_username_IDX. And let's run that one to drop our index. Supabase is just warning us that this is a destructive query because we're going to be deleting data from our database, but it's just that duplicated index. So let's run that destructive query. And now when we're creating our index on the people table using the username column, we can add the include keyword and specify any additional columns that we want to include in this index. So in this case, that's email. And so let's run just this statement to create our index. So this email column will now be stored alongside our username index, meaning if we run this query again, we're doing an index only scan, taking just over a millisecond to find more than 3,000 rows because this query is entirely covered by our username index. So now that the username index knows about the email column, can we just reuse this index to find the user based on their email? Well, what do you think? It has the data. We should be able to use it. Let's test this out by looking for a user where the email column is equal to john@supabase.com. And when we run this query, we can see it's taking a while, a long while, a very long while. I don't think this is using our index. And it's not. It's doing a sequential table scan. By including the email in the index, we're making it possible for the index to return that value, but it can't be used to filter down those results or to find a particular row. So the column or columns specified for the index can be used for searching or the where clause of a select statement, and additional columns can be included to help satisfy the columns the query is trying to select, reducing the number of times we need to do a lookup on the people table, but they can't be used for searching or helping our where clause filter down that result set. So as is always the question with indexes, why not just create a covering index for every single column? Well, because it's expensive. Every index is a copy of some of your data. And when you add those include statements, you're adding even more data that can't be used to satisfy another query. If you want to search by that extra column, you need to create an extra index. Or do you? I recommend you check out this next video to learn about multi-column indexes. They're more performant than combining two individual indexes on different columns, and if designed well, they can also be covering indexes without losing the ability to search on that extra column. And to rewind a little bit and brush up on your indexes, check out this video. Just choose one.